Yeah, you saw the thumbnail right. Sprint's 5G network is actually pretty good. You're not going to get that from the numbers alone, though. And this is a big deal, even if you're not on Sprint. So make sure you stick around the end to find out why. Hey, I'm Mike, and welcome to Better Tuber. Get bite-sized tutorials and tech reviews that you should get it or forget it. If you're new here, hit the subscribe button and click for notifications so you don't miss out on anything. Thanks to my buddy Adam Dowd, the host of the Android Authority and Digit Daily podcast. I was recently able to test out Sprint's 5G network in downtown Chicago using a Samsung Galaxy S10 5G edition. Holy crap, that's a long name. Like, Apple iPhone 11 Pro Max was long. We went all around the city testing the network and speeds from the Chicago Board of Trade and Federal Reserve buildings to the Magnificent Mile at the Water Tower, and we even went all the way down to the Shedd Aquarium and Adler Planetarium on the museum campus. Of course, when I did, I had to rent my new Bender Tube gear. Check out the link down below so you can get some for yourself. I have shirts, mugs, leggings, and I even made some of my own phone cases. Make sure you pick some up for yourself. Anything you can get helps support the channel. Now, when we finally made it back to Union Station and started downloading a season of Breaking Bad, there was one thing clear to us. This network is nothing to scoff at. For most of this trip, I remained on 5G. I didn't drop out, and even when I did drop down to LTE, I still had decent speeds and great signal. Now, what you'll see from the speed test is that they're not even close to what Verizon's pushing out there. But there's a key difference. With Verizon and their millimeter wave 5G, you have to be within line of sight of the transmitter, meaning you get like at most a block away because it doesn't go through anything. You actually have to see it. Not the case at all with Sprint Sub 6. In Chicago, they're able to cover this whole area, not because they threw a ton of money at it, but because they're just able to add it on to their LTE towers. Now, Verizon went all, shut up and take my money, and well, this is what they cover. Look, I'm never the guy to say that Sprint is getting this right, but they're getting it right. At least for initial 5G rollout. They're not coming out here with some 5G EBS or saying they got 7G. Okay, that last one was a joke, but you get my point. This gets to a lot more people on the network in a shorter amount of time. I mean, what do you think? Would you rather have ridiculous speeds, but only here and there in the city? Or would you rather have some slower speeds, but it's covered in this whole area here? Let me know down in the comments. I really would like to hear what you have to say. Here's what I'm most excited for though. It's not that Sprint has this much coverage already. It's not that I was getting 500 megs in front of the beam. It's what's coming and coming soon. Remember, Sprint isn't even my carrier. I've been with T-Mobile for almost 10 years now, and they too are rolling out their 5G. Like, last weekend. Now, surprisingly, they went lower than Sprint even with a 600 megahertz network, but they were able to push that out nationwide, which is way ahead of what everybody else is doing right now. Now, according to MKBHD, even the worst case 5G speeds are going to be equivalent to good LTE speeds. And moving forward, T-Mobile does plan on adding millimeter wave to their network. But now, how does what T-Mobile's doing tie in? Well, the Sprint T-Mobile merger is happening like sometime this month, and they plan on using Sprint's network. Remember that I said millimeter wave 5G isn't that great because even though you get those ridiculously fast speeds, you have to be like really close to it, so it's kind of useless? Well, what if you had that, T-Mobile's 600 megahertz network, and Sprint's sub 6 network? Well, that means you get coverage all over here, but then you get even better speeds here with Sprint's network. And then when they start rolling out that millimeter wave stuff, you get better, ridiculous speeds here and here and here and here. Look, it is gonna take years to get millimeter wave 5G where it needs to be. But in the meantime, if you could get those people on 5G networks with 5G phones, just by doing a few tower upgrades here and there in the meantime, that's pure genius. Okay, it's the exact opposite of what Verizon's doing. It's definitely the opposite of what AT&T is doing. Because you're taking everyone, putting them on something, yeah, it's not amazing, but it's faster than what they got, and it covers a bunch of people compared to, yeah, if you live in this neighborhood, in this city, then we're not even gonna tell you where, what blocks are covered. You might get 5G. You wanna buy this phone for an up price? Nah, fam. I'm telling you, Sprint and T-Mobile with this merger, they're doing it right. They're getting way ahead in this game. But you know what? That's it for me today, guys. Thanks again to Adam Dowd, the host of Digit Daily and Android Authority podcast, for inviting me out. You can check him out down in the links below. Make sure you tell him on Twitter that I sent you over. If you like the video, leave a like, leave a comment, and as always, I'll see you in the next one.